That was obviously the coaching from you that led to Lonzo's night, right?
I'd like to take credit for that, but no, he was special tonight. Obviously, he was his best performance so far. I think overall for just our team, it was weird. We came out flat tonight. Just we didn't have the same energy. I could kind of feel it a little bit in shoot around, but the guys were flat, and I don't know if it was because they were feeding off the crowd in the first three games. Like the didn't seem like the crowd was that into it either. So the energy wasn't there. Defensively, there were some struggles, and offensively too. We turned the ball over a bunch. We weren't getting back on defense. Our transition D was terrible. But on one of these nights where it doesn't feel like it's going to happen, I was super proud of our guys for hanging in there, because down the stretch, we made stops, and that's what it's all about. The last two or three minutes, our defense was excellent. We got some steals. We forced some tough jump shots. And then again, when we do that, we can get the rebound. We can run down and put it in Zoe's hands, and he can make plays for us.
You know, we saw Lonzo's passing in the first couple games that he played. What in that second half do you think was behind all the scoring, from three at the rim, at the free throw line?
I don't know. I think, you know, you're just seeing him mature as a player kind of in front of our eyes. You know, like I said a couple press conferences ago, I wanted him to be more aggressive offensively in terms of scoring. I mean, early on, he just had some incredible passes up the floor, hitting guys that were just amazing. But then the second half, you could see that he has the ability to get to the basket and finish. He's got his jump shot going a little bit. I think you're just seeing him, you know, feeling more and more comfortable with the NBA game.
But Jud, you played for many years in the NBA. What of his skill set do you see translating right away to the NBA level from here in summer league?
Well, his passing. I mean, that stands out immediately. I mean, he's already one of the best passers I've seen at this level. I mean, that's kind of big words, but he can really pass the ball. I think he's proven that the last three games. He's young. Obviously, there's a ton of things to improve on. But the thing that stands out to me, which is just special, is his passing ability.
How much are other players actually becoming better passers? It seems like it's happening right before our eyes because of him.
Yeah, it's a little bit contagious. You know, I think last game, when he missed the game, AC stepped up, Caruso, and he was out there kind of dishing. I mean, if we're playing the right way, moving the ball side to side, sharing it, I think everyone's happy, and it's more fun, and it's more joyful.
We talk a lot about him and his passing, but Kuzma, it seems like he also is a lot of that as well. Did you guys know that about him?
I didn't really see that in the pre-draft workout. All I noticed was his shooting ability, you know, the way he can stretch defenses. But again, you know, these guys are young and they're starting to get more comfortable out there. And his game's starting to open up for us.
Your thoughts, Coach, on what Lonzo was able to do from a defensive standpoint tonight?
It's improving. You know, I think down the stretch, like I said, the key thing was getting stops. And he did a great job. He's active. You know, he has the ability and the athletic skill to become an elite defender. It's just going to take time, and we'll be patient with that.
Instincts in terms of passing lanes and being able to create deflections and stuff like that.
Lonzo's?
Yeah,
it's incredible. It really is. You know, from day one when we had him in and his workouts, I mean, that was really the thing that stood out from day one. That's his biggest strength right now. I mean, if you get out and run that lane and you're not looking back, he's going to hit you in the side of the head. So as a player, I mean, you know that if you get out and run and spread the floor, he will find you. I mean, he found some passes over the top to our five-man, our four-man rim running. He just gets the ball, looks up, and has that, you know, incredible natural ability just to put that ball right on the money.
His ability to create deflections
I mean, you know, I don't think he's ever been known for being like an elite defender quite mm-hmm. yet. That isn't really one of the things, but he proved tonight that, you know, he can do that also. So we'll continue to work with him on that.